G'day guys, it is Trav here from Neighbourhoods. Have you ever wanted to know how to create lists, both static and dynamic, inside HubSpot? Well, guess what? You have come to the right place. Today, we're gonna go through lists and how to create lists and what the difference between both of the lists are. Meanwhile, if you want a step-by-step guide on how to do this, in the description below, we have a PDF that you can print out and share with everybody in your office so they know how to do it exactly. And just a reminder, if you want the lowdown on how to use HubSpot, make sure you subscribe and like this video, and we will continue to deliver more and more videos every single week. Without further ado, let's get started with making lists. Now, this is available across all different types of HubSpot products. So if you're on Starter, Professional, or Enterprise, this applies to every single person, which is really great. So let's jump into the platform. All right, so now we're inside the HubSpot platform. Now, in order to get here, you'd go up to Contacts and then go down to Lists. And when you go to Lists, it'll look something like this. If you've got a brand new account, it'll look pretty bare, but this is basically the layout of it. Now, when you create a whole bunch of lists, it will all list them out here. What I will suggest, just before we do get started, is if you are looking to create active lists and static lists, my main recommendation is to make sure that you give it naming conventions and give it a folder. What you don't want is after 2 years of using HubSpot, you're back in here and this is our test account, but you go through here and you've just got a whole bunch of different types of lists and you just don't know where to start. So that is a good rule of thumb before you get started. Now, straight out of the gun, I'm gonna go up to create a list and click on the orange button. Now it's gonna ask us for two different variables. Do we want a contact-based list or a company-based list? Now, contact-based lists are going to primarily center around properties of the actual contact itself, as opposed to the company-based, which will center around properties around the company. Now, in this instance, I'm gonna use a contact-based version. And you'll see over the side here, we'll go a list name. So in this instance, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to, just for example's sake, I want to find everybody inside the CRM that has an email address. So what I'm gonna go through here is I'm just gonna do a test. So test NBH has email address. This is a very, very simple example that we've got here. Now, the difference between these two, an active list and a static list. So an active list means that it will put it into the list if it meets the criteria of what you say the list is. For example, in this instance, I want to say if it has an email address, then I want it to show on this list. That's also the same that if it does not meet the criteria, it will get pulled out. So that's just a really good rule of thumb. If you look down at static list is where we manually put people inside the list. So I always like to think of it like a bucket. A static list, I can manually put people through and I can use workflows or I can manually do it myself. Active list means it'll put it in and take it out of the bucket if it does meet the criteria. And there's some really good examples on why you would use this, and I'll share these with you shortly. So in this instance, I want to do an active list because I want to know if this person has an email address inside the HubSpot CRM. And then I'll move to next. And then it will bring up with this, which can get a little bit confusing, but we'll step you through it, no worries. What we wanna do is we wanna add a filter. Now, adding a filter, we can do by clicking on the orange button, and then we'll go through all the way down the right-hand side here. And we wanna make sure that we click on contact properties because the email address is a contact property of the contact. You'll see all of these contact properties. If you've got a new account, these will come with a loaded amount of date of birth and country, region, etc. But you can create your own properties. And if you want some more information about that, you can just search inside our YouTube channel. So in here, I'm gonna type in email, and then straight underneath here, I can see email, I'm gonna click on that. So what it's gonna ask me in the edit, the group one here is that, what do I want it to do based on the email? So here it says, is equal or any to any values. What I wanna do is I wanna click up here, and this is where we got some variables. We can say is equal to any of or is not equal to any of. Now we can say that is equal to a certain email address or is not equal to it. We can say if it contains any of a letter or a number or any, maybe even a domain, starts out with any, ends with any. In this instance, we just wanna know is known, and we'll know whether the email address is known within the CRM. That also goes back to say, if we want to find email addresses inside our CRM that don't have an email address, we can actually click on unknown. So in this instance, we're going to go is known. And what's going to happen is that slowly HubSpot's going to go through and search for all the different email addresses inside the account with an email address that is known. and it usually contains, depending on the size of it. So here we go, we've got an estimated size of 48,865. So we've done a good job on collecting a lot of email addresses as well. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna save the list. Now, for the future of our account, if we ever have a contact that is created that has an email address, it'll automatically get added to that list, which is pretty good. A good rule of thumb, maybe if we want to use this, is email is unknown, because we can't communicate with people inside our CRM via email if they don't have an email. So maybe we might want to make it one that says has not got an email address, and then maybe audit that list every month to see, is this someone that we keep in our CRM? Do we move it to marketing contacts? Or obviously we move it out of marketing contacts so that we're not paying for that as well. So that is a really quick way on how to create a dynamic list or active list and what they call it inside HubSpot. We can use those lists for a variable different reasons. If you have got Marketing Pro and above, we can enroll certain active lists based on time or whenever we need to through a workflow and send them email communications. For example, if you're wanting to send out a marketing email to somebody in a certain region or town, we could use the same logic as we had in this list as well to say that we'll name the list and say, hey, this list is everybody that lives in Queensland, Australia. And then we'll go through and say, okay, we'll go up and say, okay, we want to look for state and then is any of Queensland and then click on save. Will show us all the people that live within Queensland, Australia as well. That means that I'll be able to send an email list to all of those people in Queensland, Australia, and then have contextual content within that email as well. If we step back to the list as well, and we create a list on a static list, this list here is where we can just manually go through and add people. So we've got static test, and I'm gonna click on next, and I'm going to save the list because it's a static test. If I go back into contacts, for example, I'm able to manually add people to the static list. For example, I want the first 100 people that we've got here to be added to my static list. I'll be able to go up to more and I'll be able to add to static lists, and the static list should pop up is static tests, and I can click on that and add that as well. That means that if I need to, actually a very good example of that, if you are running an event business and you are collecting specific information, you can have a form automatically add people to a static list. And that means that after the event or conference, you're able to send out an email to all of those people on the static list as well. And there you have it, all you need to know about lists in HubSpot. Well done. If you're really keen to make the most of your HubSpot investment, Neighbourhood has a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, CMS, and operations hub in depth, ensuring you and your team are best serving your customers while offering efficient internal processes. We'll include a link for this below in the description. As well, if you've gained some value from the video or you're keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget, if you're after a PDF version of this for later, or you're passing it on to a mate in need, we'll include a link in the description below as well. Well, that's it from me. Happy HubSpotting.